What's up, people? JB the drummer, Charlie Gunther the guitarist extraordinaire. Today we are going to be 6th finger. Nope. Yes, it's gone. It's disappeared. Nope, it's not there. Yeah. Okay. Today we're gonna be continuing our series on reacting to songs that are from songs that are from movies that are
my goodness. All right, so what we are doing is seeing, because JB is into the whole Spider-Man 2 themes, the heroic themes in rock, we are now reacting to official soundtrack songs to films in that genre.
Yes, that was well put. Awesome.
Thank you.
Awesome, man.
Awesome.
Today's song is going to be a band that has the most craziest name to me, Smashing Pumpkins. It's just one of those weird rock names that you're just like, why would you... Not bad. It's just like, Smashing Pumpkins. Who thought of that? You know, it makes me laugh. But yeah, Smashing Pumpkins. Mm-hmm. The end is beginning in the end.
Wow. The end is beginning in the end.
What movie is this for?
It is for... Batman and Robin.
Okay, Batman and Robin. Cool. Well, without further ado,
the
worst in the series. Well, let's not start any beefs. All right, let's go. The riff that just played, that feels a little bit like Batman. I've got to try and put myself back in. When did this come out? The '90s, right?
I think it was 1997.
I'm trying to put myself.
1997.
I'm trying to put myself back in those, in that headspace. Obviously, but in those times, there wasn't a lot of superhero movies. Like, people didn't really know what to do, what it would sound like, what is, you know, how would we translate this to the big screen? So I'm even thinking musically, I don't think they knew how to, maybe, possibly how to capture it. But I'm just, even just sonically, I'm trying to put myself back in those times, appreciate some of the choices of melodies and instruments. Because at the minute, I'm just like, okay, this is 2022 brain. I need to go back just to try and understand the gravity of, you know, trying the whole atmosphere of the release. Okay, because
now this is when I would say you are thinking too hard.
All right,
like, just look, the category is, do you like the song? Right,
yeah.
What about it, if you, what about the song that you don't or do like?
Yes.
And does it fit
right
the genre?
Say less. Mm-hmm. Say less.
Page 2, the replays run. Yeah.
There's nothing left, bro.
But wait. To that end. There you go.
There was nothing left. I should have stopped that halfway through.
All right, so what are you saying?
That was awful. I didn't like the song.
Okay.
I liked the riff. The riff gave me like a 90s, like X-Men 92, 97 type vibe.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like the series, that kind of that captured that. But in terms of it being a Batman soundtrack and what we know of Batman and how he is as a character, I don't think that had nothing to do with Batman. That was a self-indulgent love letter for themselves, to themselves. it was like we totally ignored the brief and we're just gonna do and you gotta bear in mind, this is the first I'm ever hearing Smashing Pumpkins,
right?
So for me, that riff is dope, but when it came to the brief, like, this is for Batman. Have you guys ever watched a Batman anything?
Okay.
Wait, no, I know what you're going to say. Okay. Because the movie is a bit playful and it's a bit. It's okay. It's very playful.
A bit.
This was too spacey for me. This was way too spacey for me. It sounded like in some galaxy somewhere. It wasn't grounded enough. It was like this was for like, you know, some galaxy warrior or something like that. It wasn't Batman-ish. And I know what you're saying, it was playful, it's very colorful, it's very you know, I know what you're trying to say, but it just didn't hit the mark for me. They just went the wrong way. Again, this doesn't mean I don't like Smashing Pumpkins, it's my first song of theirs, but the brief that we're listening, does this fit for the movie and stuff like that? It doesn't for me. It was just like, nah.
Okay, all right. For me, now, I don't know if for the fact that I've had history with Smashing Pumpkins, that influences
your decision. It does.
Much my decision.
Okay,
but influences my knowledge.
You get the vision. You get the vision. You understand what the right. What the, yeah.
Oh yeah, of the yeah, but like I think I think it actually does capture.
Okay.
Now it might not necessarily seem like it would capture Batman as himself.
Yes.
Right. But added with Robin, now you're thinking this is a film with Batman, Robin,
Poison Ivy,
right? Bane, yeah. Who looks like anyway, right? Right. Arnold Schwarzenegger as as Dr. Freeze.
Mr. Freeze, yeah.
Yeah, right? Okay, all of that is already a stretch, but, right, you're talking the actual concept of what was actually made, I should say, like the actual thing that was actually made is a goofy movie.
I hear you.
Like, it was very colorful, it was very silly, right? All right, sure, it had its, you know, heroic moments, but it wasn't like no Batman sinister in the darkness, blah blah blah. This was Batman just like, hey, hi Freeze, hey, okay. I'm Batman,
okay,
you know, and he's got his
spandex. Well, it wasn't spandex, but his suit, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, and he's got his nipples going. Oh, and
was that in that suit? Was that suit?
I think it's either one of them.
Right.
Joel Schumacher movies.
So you're saying it was a perfect. It was a goofy movie.
Yes.
Which needed a quirky song. I think quirky. No, I agree with you.
Right.
I agree with you. I do believe it should have been quirky. I get you. It couldn't. It's not like Dark Knight. It's not like, okay.
Right.
We need Zimmer on this or something like that. Mm. I hear you, but. I think the, do you know what? I think the added textures of like the whole spacey thing, like there was a lot of like those sort of simps and stuff going on. It just gave me like intergalactic vibes. It never gave me like Batman vibes, because you can still do quirky, but without all the futurist. It just sounded too futuristic. You know what I mean? It didn't sound quirky and like Gotham-y, because you could make it sound Gotham-y and quirky without make wheel, you know, all those little effects and stuff. So
right.
Yeah, I just, and maybe I'm not a fan of the songs. It just doesn't sound. It's not for me, I suppose. I hope that isn't the rest of the band, though. I hope that isn't.
Well, the thing is, I at this point, this is kind of like a transition.
Okay, from, cool. Right.
They fired their drummer.
Right.
They just got a new drummer. They're starting to experiment into new sounds.
Right.
This is kind of like, yeah, this is the
transition. We're moving on. All right, cool. All right. I'm happy. But yeah, what you guys let us know what you think. If you thought it was too, if you agree with me and thought it was a bit too spacey, you know, for the track, or if you think it fits, you know, leave your comments down below. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Join the Patreon and peace.
Peace.